Hey, eyes up here. What are some of the most effective and easy ways for you to share your appreciation of a cast member? Let's talk about it. If you're new to my channel, I'd like to welcome you here. I'm a full-time cast member at Walt Disney World. I'm a bus driver. I'm here to share with you my journeys and adventures from a cast member point of view. So if you've ever worked in any kind of guest services field where you're working with customers or guests, you know that for the most part, people are rude. Guests, customers, patrons, whatever you want to call them, they're rude. They're unappreciative. They come in, they leave a mess. And if you don't get things right, that's the first thing they do is complain, right? How many times have you gone to a fast food restaurant through a drive-thru and you got home and the fries were cold or something was missing from your order and you call up and you complain, I want free food, and you're upset, and you should be. But how many times have you got home and the fries were hot, they were fresh, they got your order completely right, everything was good, and you called them and said, hey look, I just want to let you know that you did a really good job, I really appreciate your service. Not that often. Most of the time you only hear the negative, you only hear the complaints. So if you go to Disney, whether it's Walt Disney World, Disneyland, or even your local Disney store in the mall, and you have a cast member that just goes out of their way, goes above and beyond to make your day extra special, extra magical, there are a couple different ways that you can return the favor, pay it forward as it were, show your support, show your appreciation, show your thanks, because most of the time we get attacked with complaints and negativity and anger and yelled at, and every now and then it's nice to hear something nice. So I'm going to go over with you five different ways that you can show your appreciation and thanks to a cast member. I'm going to start from the easiest one for you to the most involved one for you, but interestingly enough, it's also the easiest one for you is the less beneficial for a cast member. So number five is easy, but it's really not that big of a help for a cast member. The higher up you get, number one is a little bit more involved for you, but really not that hard, but it's the most beneficial for the cast member. So we'll go over these based on how happy and thankful you are, the higher up the list you want to go. Really the easiest thing you can do, and it really does make a lot of difference, is just a simple thank you, just a smile, just a wave, hi, friendly, thank you, just a thank you, that's all it takes. We get a lot of people who are just frustrated, they're angry, I can't believe the bus hasn't been, I've been waiting an hour for this bus, when in reality they've been waiting about 17 minutes. What's taking you so long? How come these big buses don't fit the wheelchairs? People just complain. It's been hot. I've been waiting in line. Just a simple, hey, thank you, makes a huge amount of difference. I remember one time about a month or so ago, I don't even remember where I was. I think I was coming into Magic Kingdom late at night. Park was already closed. It's hot outside, people are waiting, and I pulled into this bus stop, we call them load zones, at Magic Kingdom, and there were these three young ladies who were waiting there, and I opened the door, and they came in and they said, thank you so much, you are our knight in shining armor. They were just so appreciative that it was hot outside and they got an air-conditioned bus, and just that little thank you really goes a long way. So just make sure you're kind to cast members, just thank them and be nice. So the next thing we'll talk about is mildly controversial, mildly divisive, and that's cash tips. Look, if you're staying at a restaurant, if you're eating at a restaurant, you're going to want to tip your server, I get it. But even then, a lot of times a tip is already added in to the receipt. Like I went to Whispering Canyon a couple weeks ago for myself and three other people, and usually if it's parties of six or eight or whatever, the gratuity's already added in. There were four of us. And when I got the receipt, there was 18% gratuity already added in. So a lot of times they're already pre-adding the tip. So make sure you look at that. But if you're eating somewhere, yeah, you're going to want to give a cash tip. Housekeeping, or mousekeeping as they call it, you're going to want to give them a tip. But a lot of times people now are opting out of getting housekeeping to avoid paying a tip and getting some kind of Disney gift card instead, whatever. But other than those two lines of work, believe it or not, most of the time we are not even supposed to get cash tips. Like, I'm not allowed, or it's highly frowned upon for me as a bus driver to take a cash tip, and other places too. front desk at the hotel or whatever. Cash is great. I mean, hey, cash is king, right? Money's great, but I'm not supposed to get cash tips, and I'm really just doing my job. So don't give drivers or anyone else cash tip. It's great if you're housekeeping or mousekeeping or whatever. It's funny because a lot of people know that and they try to get around it, and I've had some funny experiences where people have tried to tip me. Like, if someone tries to give me money, usually what I say is, you know what, are you going out to eat tonight? Yeah. They'll try to give me $5 or $3 or $10, whatever, and I'll say, tell you what, where are you going out to eat tonight? Oh, we're going to Sanaa. All right, when you go to Sanaa, I want you to take this money, give it to your server, and I'll point to my name tag, and I'll say, tell them Icky from Orlando, the bus driver, gave them this money. And they're like, oh, that's cool, that's really nice. Sometimes I'll try to trick you because they know you can't take tips, so they'll send up a little kid, a little 5-6-year-old kid, to give you money. And who's going to say no to a kid? So I'll get down to the kid, I'll say, hey, do you like ice cream cones? Do you like the Mickey ice cream bars? Yeah, I like the Mickey ice cream bars. I want you to take this money. Next time you go to the park, get yourself a Mickey ice cream bar. It's from old Icky from Orlando. He gave you that. And I'm like, oh, thank you. And they'll run back and tell my parents, Icky bought me an ice cream bar. And they get so upset in a funny way because, you know, they were trying to give me a tip and they know they can't. One time, I had these two guests, and long story, but Epcot runs buses to Art of Animation, but it doesn't run buses to Pop Century because they want you to take the Skyliner, which Art of Animation and Pop Century are right next to each other. But if someone comes out of Epcot and they're going to Pop Century, and I tell them, sorry, you can't go to Pop Century, you got to go back in Epcot, you got to go all the way back to the back of the park, get on the Skyliner. So anyway, there was this elderly couple, both of them were in scooters, you know, the little wheelchair scooters. They were in the Art of Animation stop, so I pulled in there, get them on the bus, and they said, oh, we're actually going, I said, going to Art of Animation, right? And they said, yeah, well, we wanted to go to Pop Century, but we didn't want to go all the way back to the park. So Art of Animation and Pop Century are right next to each other, so we'll just take our electric scooters. We'll just ride from Art of Animation over to Pop Century. I said, don't worry about that. I'll take you to Pop Century, you know. Magical moment, right? Wasn't really supposed to, but I went out of my way, above and beyond, to help them. So, like, thank you so much. When I get them there, I take, you know, you got to load the scooters in separately. It's a little bit of a process when you have two of them, but they were the only people on the bus. So anyway, I get the wife off, get her down the ramp, get her out, get the husband, get him unbuckled, get him down the ramp. When I get him down the ramp, he says, come here. He leans in, he says, check your seat really good when you get ready to leave. And I'm like, okay. So I get the ramp back up, get everything back place, go look, and when I go back to my driver's seat, there's a $10 bill sitting in my seat. And I look out the front door, and he's sitting there, and he's like, and he just rolls away. He got me because he knew I wasn't supposed to get a tip, but he gave me one anyway. Again, bottom line, cash is king. Money is great, but we're really not supposed to take cash tips, and there are better ways. The next one I'm going to share with you is much better, but they get even better from there. So the next way that I think is a great way for you to show your appreciation and thanks to cast members, which is actually way more meaningful than even cash, is to give cast members a homemade thank you. And I've seen lots of situations, lots of examples, especially in mousekeeping, where people will make little envelopes that they'll put the cash tip in, they'll color it, thank you so much, or they'll give cast members a little, they'll make little thank yous at home that they will hand out and give to cast members along the way. And I think that is really, really awesome. I'm gonna show you an example of one real quick, and I'll talk a little bit more about it. It's awesome because, well, let me just show you. So I didn't actually get this, my wife got this, but this is like a little wooden coin. It's like stained along the edges, it looks like, and it's like a little wooden medallion, which is funny because back in the day, bus drivers used to have these little wooden transportation medallions they would give out. But it's this little piece of wood, and it's got a, you know, a hidden Mickey in the middle, and it looks like even the inside is stained. And it's just something that you can give to cast members. And I'm sure that this family, I didn't actually get this, my wife did. She gave it to me, or showed it to me, and I'm just showing it to you. I'm sure what this family did as part of their build-up and part of their excitement to go to Disney is they made these as a family. And they probably made a certain amount, 50 or 100, whatever, and they said that they would give them to cast members as thank yous. But this, as cool as this is, it gets even better because check this out. When I flip it over, it says, we love cast members. And the words, we love cast members, it looks like they're burned in or maybe they're inked in. But the heart itself, I don't know if you can see this, the heart, and I think maybe even the words, the heart is like imprinted. It's like stamped. Yeah, the words are too. They're like stamped in. It's like imprinted. We love, so they actually took this and they stamped it in. So I'm guessing that this was probably a project, like a DIY home project that they did. The mom and dad or whatever, the parents and the kids made this, and they put a lot of time and effort into it, and it's pressed in so they could take these and make a bunch of them and give them out to cast members as they saw fit. I'll tell you right now, as nice as it is to get a $5 tip or even a $10 tip, the most I've ever seen was a $20 tip, which is great. But even that, this little coin is much better than that. It's much more meaningful. It's just, again, I don't care how bad of a day you're having, how bad of a week you're having. You get something like that from a little kid, it just melts your heart and it makes it all worth it. Little homemade tips like this, again, it's cool for you because it's a Friday night activity or whatever that you can do as a family. Look online, look on Etsy or Google, whatever. I'm sure there are hundreds of ideas of cast member thank yous that you can make. Make up a bunch of them, even if it's just a little piece of paper where the kids draw on it and, you know, make a little thank you and give it to the cast members. That is awesome. The next thing I'm going to talk about, really, really step it up, because now you're not just saying something or giving something to the driver. You're actually calling attention to them, to the company, and saying, hey, Dizzney, look. Look what this cast member did. Pay attention to them. And the next two are really important because you, the cast member, gets extra special recognition from the company. So if you really feel like going out of your way and getting someone else involved and telling someone, hey, pay attention to this cast member. They did a really good job. It really, really helps out, like tremendously. So if you get someone who really did something great, please go and do one of these things, because I'll share with you in a minute how important it is for us. So as it turns out, if you use a Twitters, which I really don't that much, Dizzney World is very active on Twitter. And there are two different ways you can really compliment guests by mentioning them on Twitter. Now normally you would go to this one, Walt Dizzney World Today, which is, what is it? At WDW Today. But right now, because of the lockdowns and everything, it says the park's open, but this account is not currently being monitored. So you can send a message to this one, which is normally what people say to do, or you can, let me see if I can go to this other one. Walt Dizzney World Guest Service, which is just at WDW Guest Service. So go onto your Twitter and go to at WDW Today and at WDW Guest Service. Make sure you get the name of the cast member and where they're from. Look at their name tag and say, hey, I was on Frozen Ride at Epcot, and Ashley from Milwaukee really helped me out. She helped, you know, we were stressed out, whatever. She went and got us water, whatever. And send a message at WDW Guest Service and at WDW Today. And make sure you put in there who it is and where they're from and what they did. And then end it with hashtag castcompliment. So, yeah, right there. Hashtag castcompliment. If you want to shout out a cast member, and you want to make sure that Dizzney sees it, this is a way to do it, because Dizzney does check Twitter. Rest assured, they know what's going on online. I'm not sure if it works on Facebook, probably, but Twitter's the best way. Do this, at WDW Guest Service or WDW Today, and put castcompliment, and Dizzney will track them down. Dizzney has a whole team of social network people. What will happen is they will get this, they will go to the manager of that area or that ride or that restaurant or wherever it is, and they will track down that cast member. They will print out your compliment, they will go to their manager, and that cast member will get a picture taken with their manager with that compliment, and they'll post it around, you know, the company, around their location, whatever. Sometimes if the person goes really above and beyond, it'll actually go on the company-wide website for everybody to see. And that really makes someone's day when they get recognized. That's really nice. But the next one is the ultimate. The ultimate. I'm about to tell you why. If you really like what someone did, this is the way to give a cast member a compliment or recognition that will literally stay with them forever. This is what you really, really need to do. There is a system in place in the Walt Disney Company website, the employee portal, across all of the Walt Disney Company, Walt Disney World, Disneyland, Disney Tokyo, China, Paris, whatever, even the Disney stores, even Imagineers, everybody, all the way up to Bob Chapek and Bob Iger themselves are part of this network. There's a process in this internal portal by which cast members and managers and such can recognize each other, can point out something good that a cast member did. It goes upon the five keys, which used to be four, but now it's five, with inclusion being the fifth key, where you can point out how a cast member did something good that either demonstrated, you know, safety, courtesy, efficiency, show, or inclusion. And that cast member will get a notification next time they log on to the company website, and they'll get, you can recognize somebody, or somebody can recognize you, and you'll get a nice little note on your company website. And that recognition goes to your manager. They get a notification that you were recognized, and that recognition goes on your permanent file. Your permanent file. You hear that? Every cast member has a file of when you've been late, when you've called out sick, when you did this, when you've done that, whatever. And there's a permanent record of every time that someone has said, hey, you did a good job. That goes on your permanent record forever. The beauty is that you, as a guest, can compliment a cast member through that internal system, and it will go on their permanent record forever. Here's how you do it. If you're staying at a resort and you're out at the parks or you're out wherever and the cast member does something really good and you're like, wow, that was awesome. What I want you to do is when you get back to your resort, go up to the front desk, go to the concierge, go to the check-in in the lobby or whatever the case may be. And when you go to there, go to the cast member at the desk and say, hey, I had a really good experience with a cast member. They went out of their way above and beyond to make my day magical, and I want to give them a compliment. And make sure you use this word. I want to recognize them now. Make sure you use the words recognize now. Those are important, okay? I want to recognize now this cast member. And what that cast member at the front desk will do is they'll go into this internal portal, which I just told you about, and they'll be able to put in a compliment on behalf of a guest, on behalf of you, and share. And then you say, hey, I was in line at Frozen, whatever, I was hot, my kid was crying, cast member went and got me a drink, brought it to me, didn't charge me anything for it, thank you so much. And that front desk person will put that in to that cast member's, they'll look them up, make sure you get their name and where they work and what they do and where they're from. That cast member will look them up and give them that recognition that will stay on their file forever. You might be thinking, all right, I'm not staying at a Disney resort. I'm staying off property at the Wyndham Hotel or Days Inn, or, you know, I rented a condo off property somewhere. That's fine too. What you do is you just go to the guest services at whatever park you're at the front desk. Every park has a guest services. Disney Springs has a guest services. Blizzard Beach, you know, every place has a guest services at the front desk. Go to guest services and do the same thing. I had a really good experience. I really want to recognize this cast member now. Can you help me recognize now this cast member? And they will do it. The beauty of that is, again, that goes on there. They're going to get, a lot of times, the manager will do the same thing as before, print it out, give it to them, and that recognition will go on their permanent record forever. Why is that important? Because it's good to have good things on your permanent file, right? Permanent file. If that person ever down the road wants to be promoted, you know, they're going to look at that person's permanent file. How many times have they called out? How many times have they been late? How many times have they been recognized by someone else as having done a good job? There's also something you may not have noticed. I don't know how it is at Disneyland, but here at Disney World, if you look at most cast members' name tags, it's light colored. It's not really white, but it's kind of an off, like an eggshell off-white. The new 50th ones are going to have kind of a different look to them. I'm not sure exactly what yet, but they're a lighter color. Well, there's something called a legacy award, where if you as a cast member become really good, you're really liked, you're really well respected, you do a really good job, you can earn what's called a legacy award, which instead of a white name tag or a light one, you'll have a blue name tag, like a dark blue, like my shirt here. Dark blue name tag, it's like inverse. Instead of it being white with blue letters, it's blue with white letters. And instead of a blue circle around and a blue castle, it's a white castle. It's the opposite. So that means that that cast member has been a really good cast member over the years. And these little things that go on their record will help get them to that legacy status. So just a couple little ways you can really show your appreciation. And it's not that hard. You know, after you get back from the park, stop by the front desk, take 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Hey, you know, Ashley at Yak and Yeti really helped us out, you know. Or, you know, we were at Magic Kingdom, we went to Casey's Corner, we mobile ordered our food, we stepped on the train track, twisted our ankle, all of our food went everywhere. This guy, Sam Balloons, came over and got us all new food, walked us over to first aid, did a really bang-up job. I really want to recognize this cast member. Take 10 minutes, go to the front desk, go to guest services, and say, I want to recognize this cast member for doing a great job. Because I'm telling you, we get so much negative interaction. We get so many people complaining and venting on us. It's really nice to get something pleasant, just a thank you. But if someone really goes out of their way, take the time and really thank them, because a lot of times this line of work is thankless. It's fulfilling, it's great, I love doing it, but it can be thankless. So thank you for watching. Hope you got something out of it. Please, next time you go to Disney, go out of your way to be kind to the cast members. They're working out in this heat all the time. Do you think it's hot for the week you're here? They're out here in this heat all the time. So go out of your way to thank them and be kind. And remember, Wasio na hofu is Swahili for they who have no fear. Hurry back.